Good evening and welcome to Joe's Pub. The show will be starting in a few minutes and we'd like to thank you all for joining us. As we gather after so long apart, we ask that all audience members wear masks when moving throughout the space and while seated when not eating or drinking. Thank you for joining us and helping us to reopen safely. We hope you enjoy the show.
Never come back. Hi, everybody. Hi. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Christian De Gré Cárdenas. I am the composer of everything you're going to see tonight. If you don't know me, that's because somebody dragged you here. I'm sorry. But we'll try to make this as painless for you as possible. Tonight is both a celebration of 15 years of Mind the Art Entertainment, which is a company I've been artistic director of since 2007. And that is unfortunately no longer continuing because of the pandemic. We had 6 shows canceled back to back. It was very hard. But we're continuing to make art. So tonight is not a sad night. The songs are sad, but we're not sad. we're going to just show you some highlights. Highlights of some of our shows, some of our operettas, some of our comedies, some of our dramas over the last couple of years. So we're going to start off with a piece from the show called Whiskey Pants, the Mayor of Williamsburg. Whiskey Pants was written about a world after the apocalypse, where no one else wants to dream anymore, they don't want to care anymore, so all they do is drink whiskey all day. All the faucets in the town are full of whiskey. People bathe in whiskey, drink whiskey, live in whiskey. And the one rule is you can't dream, because dreaming leads to heartbreak. So, with this wonderful company, which I will introduce later, we're going to start with Dangerous to Dream, as a father is telling his daughter it is time to get drinking and stop dreaming about painting. So, here's Dangerous to Dream.
So blue, my dear.
Papa, did you not ever have a dream?
It's dangerous to dream, to want too much and then to strive, to want a life, a wife and a son.
Dangerous to dream.
It's dangerous to hope, to cope, to love, to rise above the push and shove you're tired
of. Dangerous to dream, dangerous to dream. But Papa,
life may not be what it seems, but still, it's dangerous to dream.
Dangerous to dream, dangerous to dream, dangerous to dream.
A child in school can be anything they wish. He is not a lion or a king or a talking fish. But let's decrease the difficulty factor. Let's save his kid, he wants to be an actor. He learns to speak, to move, to memorize his lines. But he ends up serving pasta and picking wines. Although he did everything that he knew he should do. The dream of art still broke his heart, 'cause he's no good.
So we should not even try.
It's dangerous to dream.
It's dangerous to dream.
To want too much and to strive to be in light so bright and lush.
It's dangerous to dream.
It's dangerous to hope.
It's dangerous to hope.
To cope, to love, to rise above the push and shove you're tired of.
Dangerous to dream. But Papa,
life may not be what it seems, but still, it's dangerous to dream.
Dangerous to dream. Dangerous to dream. Dangerous to dream.
A little girl who dreams of saving many lives to be the reason a patient may survive. And even though there is a world of work to conquer, this little girl, she says, I wanna be a doctor. She goes to school to learn the trade for many years. She gets too many loaves and sheds too many tears. And then the day the final grade would be upheld, it broke her heart. She wasn't smart, and so she failed.
But at least she tried.
It's dangerous to dream. To want too much, a life that's good, a life that could find another life to touch.
Dangerous to dream, dangerous to dream.
It's dangerous to hope.
Dangerous to hope.
To cope, to love, to rise above the push and shove you're tired of.
Dangerous to dream, dangerous to dream.
might sound a bit extreme, but life can split you at the seams. Oh, it's dangerous to dream. It all until you fall into the hole. It's dangerous to love, so don't you blink, and then you think a little drink might help when your heart begins to sink. It's just a dream within a dream. The line is blurred, life is just a dream.
Great, I forgot to give context. So these are works from pieces that we call operettas. We call them operettas because they're hybrid forms of musical theater and opera. The singers here represent both of those worlds. There's not a more technical definition. I'm not gonna argue with you about it. It's just what we're calling it. It is what it is. So you'll hear a range of styles of coming in from those camps. The next piece is also from that same show, Whiskey Pants, and it is called Somewhere in the Sky. And it is his daughter ends up finding this stranger coming to Williamsburg. And she wonders who that is, and ends up being her brother, who's come back to try to save her from this world of drinking. I will say, anybody who got to see Acedia at the Brick, the first song was sung by Charles, who in that show was Carl, the stagehand, and also Carlos in the original piece, and one-armed Carl. So that's the end of Charles's venue, was what we just saw. These are his children. So here is Somewhere in the Sky.
Welcome to Williamsburg.
You must mean welcome home. I was born in this hippie honeycomb.
If you didn't like it here, why did you come back?
Well, why does anyone go searching for the things they lack? A frightened mom, a worried son, a bus, a car, a plane, another place, no father there. New song, but old refrain. I had a sister once, a long, long time ago. I once had a father that I never took the time to know. When I was 7, my mother asked me to go, and I loved her too much to say no. Now I don't recall those things at all. They say you never should, I say you shouldn't. The past is full of pain.
I heard I had a brother too, and he sounded a lot like you. He left when I was very young, and my mother left me too. A father left, a baby cried, a door was shut for good. I don't recall those things at all.
Star won't be where you want him to be, but somewhere he'll reappear, just like me.
I see another star hanging up there that just not moving off.
It stays true.
A hanging heavenly flare, that star will never fall.
That one's you. Every traveler sees you. Left me on my own, and I've been searching for a place to call home. And I've been moving from this place to that, and I almost forgot who you are, and I've worn away each welcome mat.
One star is slightly less bright, dimmed by its journey.
Throughout the night, I'm going to give a couple of thank yous. So you'll have to bear with it. I'm going to do it anyway. You're stuck with me. The first one is to Frigid New York, if there's anybody here from Frigid. Because Whiskey Pants was a show that was premiered there, as well as three other pieces of mine. So just very thankful for one of the last remaining theater festivals in New York. And so great thank you to Frigid for all they've done. This next piece is from another festival, from Fringe NYC. Anybody here from Fringe, you can also shout, yeah. I see you all. You can just be quiet about it. But this is a show we did called Beware the Chupacabra. And it was about this American inventor in the 1920s called Teddy Baskins, who goes down to the jungles of Mexico to find the Chupacabra. And within it, he discovers this little monster and grows grossly enamored with it. As the show kind of progresses, he has this moment where he doesn't understand if he's going to be able to save this Chupacabra from the obviously Republican evil overlords that are coming from the U.S. to kill him, as every show has. He starts to wonder if his little monster in him will survive. This show is also, in a lot of ways, an allegory for me, has been as a composer for mental health. And I think Teddy Baskin's struggle with his own demons is something that I've always been very fond of. And to help guide me through writing this show is the wonderful R. Patrick Alberti, who is our lyricist and book writer. Patrick has also been putting up with me since 2005, maybe. he has been associate artistic director of the company, producing director of the company, and just a wonderful thank you to the man who has put up with everything I've ever done. So, Patrick, thank you. And so to carry us into my little monster and me, the amazing Charlie Tingen will lead us through as Teddy Baskin.
Kept at a distance, a man of low class, meant to only fit brass to the dresses I suture. Each I've tried to ignore, drown out with persistence, working hard to unveil the adventurous tale of my oncoming future. When you live in your head, every hour's lonely, though the colors are so bright. At the end of the night, all you're left with is dreams. So if given a chance, just one chance to pursue the loose thread of a hope that could vault you ahead, how could you not jump and grab for the seam? So I pulled and I traveled, it all came unraveled, this life that I'd found fell away. Now the fact of the matter's my needles and tatters, the needles astray, and I'm nothing but prey. I'm unwound, leaving nothing to see. This little monster that's me, how did I get sucked in? One more cog in their scheming, a delusional boy taken in by their ploy. So I bought what they sold, cause I thought it was gleaming, but behind their far reign they mean me only pay. Think that they'd see my machine and be part of their scene. Did I really care for a love never there? Did I just go along to prove I belong there? But these wolves circle close, my scent thick on their nose, and they're not far behind the one they came to find. Can they take? Choice. The find of the century, legend of history, who's only now found her real voice. With it, the fog of my fear starts to clear as I hear a solution appear. I am alive and they pardoned my high. Now I aim to beat them at their game. So we'll go to the world where these wolves will not dare bring their dirt team to bear. And they'll turn and they'll flee.
Music for singers, just so we're all clear. Simple things. So that was the first part of the show, which I call the dreaming section. These are all dreamers who are trying to persevere against adversity. The second part is conflict. So it's all the things that kind of hold us back. And I picked a couple of shows to represent kind of the things that we've all been going through over the last couple of years. I don't know what happened to you guys, but it's been strange on this end. So we're going to start with some songs from a show called Jack of Hearts, Master of None. Jack of Hearts, Master of None was last done at Here Arts Center, so thank you to Here Arts as well for that run. It is a show about a chronic gambler who is a perfectionist, and he decides that relationships to him are like a game of blackjack. And he will play and he will bet every single hand, go all in until he hits 21. Anything less than about a 21 is not good enough. And that's how he treats all of his relationships. So, at this point in the show, Jack is at his bar with his bartender, who he's had kind of a crush on for a number of years. He's just been broken up with. And he's crying, you know, because he's got some white fragility, male fragility. So he's crying, and nothing to do with you, Tony. This is the character. So he's, you know, kind of crying to himself. And they sit there at this moment getting drunk, thinking, how did we get here? How did we get to this point? So the great Emma Grimsley and Tony Mollett in How Did We Get Here from Jack of Hearts.
Shame on you, Jack, my old friend. Distraught that she played blackjack with your heart. You'll never hit 21. If you sit there bubbling up, be a man, let's get you a shot.
Just got up and left that morning. No goodbye without a word. Oh, my friend, pour me another. Let's just drink this shitty night away.
Salud.
Salud.
The next drink is the right one. Just drink up and we can move on.
To the next drink, you know you'd like one.
Why don't we drink until the dawn?
Think I had some
answers. I used to think I had some standards.
How did we get here? The girls I dated all had prospects.
The guys I dated all were projects.
How did we get here?
Come on, Jack, grab those shots off the table. Get your hands on a glass. Let's sip away from the edge.
The next drink, and we'll feel better. We can watch the sun rise through our beers. The next drink may be even wetter. Who knows? How did we get here?
Salud.
Salud. Like your total lack of decorum. How did we get here? Salute, salute. I like the way you really see me.
Salute, I like the way you act so see me.
Salute, how did we get here? Salute, salute. Salute, salute. Salute, salute. Either kiss me or have another. Be my whiskey, be my lover.
Want me, whisk me undercover. But maybe first won't you pour me another. How did we get here?
Salute, salute. Salute, salute. Salute, salute.
So that song, and actually eight of all of our songs tonight, were co-written by my wonderful librettist of many years, Joseph Rhys Anderson. So I just want to give a huge shout out to this man who is, we've now written 9 shows together. So to Joe Rhys, when I send you this video later tonight, like I promised, thank you. You'll get to watch what happened. cool, we're going to do another song from Jack of Hearts. So this is right after that moment. They do end up having this kind of wild affair at the bar that night. And she wakes up the next morning and goes, oh, maybe I could give this a chance. So here's Emma Grimsley with 7 Seconds from Jack of Hearts, Master of None.
Yeah.
seconds. 7 seconds is what they say. In 7 seconds, a girl can decide what she's going to say, yay or nay. For us, it was never that quick. The first 7 seconds were bad. We spent the next 7 years trying to find out what kind of friendship we had. In the first 7 seconds, you made a fool of yourself in the bar. In the next 7 years, I learned what a real mess you are. So yeah, okay, it took this long to know, and sure, okay, but who knew that, yeah, okay, how was I supposed to know that I could end up being right here with you after all this time supporting you? I spent last night exploring you. Maybe it's finally time to own this, for in last night's embrace, for in that moment, the last 7 years felt like the first 7 seconds, as if you just wandered into my view, as if this whole time you'd been walking toward me, and me, I was waiting for you. 7 years of falling, and 7 seconds made it clear. Drunken time flew on by, every second was a year. 7 years it has taken.
So now we're going to do a piece from our last show that we did at the Brick. We did a show called Fish With Her Feelings at Frigid New York in March 2020, which was then going to get extended. You can imagine what happened for years. And then we did get to open it at the Brick. And not just that show alone, but also with two other companion pieces as a trilogy called Acedia. It was a wild 5.5 hour experience, reaching three things of surrealist apocalyptic theater. Unfortunately, we were unable to open properly because of COVID, and then we had to close early because of COVID again. But the cast of Acedia is here for the most part, so I just want to give a huge shout out to these humans. And so we're going to do a song called Tsunami from Acedia. And this is a piece about a man who is a survivor of suicide a number of times and is an alcoholic who has a very strange relationship with his siblings. And he remembers that one night that he tried to hang himself in a hotel room and how his sister came to his aid. So here is the light part of the show with Tsunami from Acedia.
So you close your bill at the bar. Why did I let it get this far? The lonely road is cold at night, yet you long for the rain. No, it's not home, but it's hard not to weep. So you try to ease to sleep, and you wake the next morning, and everything hurts.
59. Oh, honey, just don't drink for a while. You grasp with nothing to hold. Your fingers grow cold. Just a glass of a day-old champagne, and you blissfully drown in your shame. The end is coming. Can you weather the storm? Sixteen drinks and you don't know your pain. You're not able to fight off your cane. You look for a friend and you see a worn belt. And you whisper goodbye. You pull up a chair and you sip your last sip. Guess you're really sinking the ship. Worn, warm leather kisses your throat. And you drown in your and you drown in your own tsunami. And you're gasping for death, and the storm takes your breath, and you drown in the waves of your pain. And the ocean turns black, and your head gets snapped back, and a siren calls out your name. And the ocean's no more, and your ship comes ashore, and you feel the warmth of the sun. As you wake to the taste of the salt of your sweat, the siren sings her song of regret. And you've been saved. You've been saved. You've been
Tony Mowat, I met when we did our first off-Broadway show. And since then, I've dragged him through the worst circumstances after that. Where I'm like, here, let me send you a MIDI file 24 hours before I have to present at BMI. You can sing along to this in a three-octave range, right? Yeah. Or here's some guitar music. I didn't write anything but chords. Have fun. So he's amazing, and I adore him. So we're going to move now into a piece from what is probably our most recognizable show. And this is Fatty Fatty No Friends. Fatty Fatty No Friends has been at Fringe, at NAMMT, at Green Room, at a ton of places. And it is a show about this young boy who is bullied for being perceived as to be overweight. And so he gets angry at his tormentors and decides that they're going to call me a Fatty Fatty No Friends, then I'm going to eat them. So this is Tommy, our protagonist, as the children in the schoolyard, as well as the demons in his head, are tormenting him, and he decides that it's time to chomp him. So this is Chomping at Their Bits from Fatty Fatty No Friends.
I can't do this anymore. Can't go through this anymore. Oh, I am done. The making fun is not so fun for me. I haven't eaten today, but I get beaten anyway. Oh, I am done. I'm getting hungry.
fish just a bite. I've got such an appetite. Incomplete. Not a carrot on a stick, not a cookie, that's not it. Just a morsel, just a bit. I need some meat, not just any meat will do. Maybe I should start with you. Revenge is sweet, and now it's due. It's time to eat.
Today is
it's time today. I will not let them make me father work away. Today I stand. Today they fall. Today I'll help them stand. I'll show them all. They think that I'm pathetic, that I've got no way to fight back, just cause I'm not athletic. They cannot treat me like that. My stomach is a growling beast that's chomping at the bit. My mouth is watering and my heart's a big bit. This craving is amazing and I'm going to follow it. I need to taste some meat too, or I'm going to swallow it. It's time to
we're going to go from what was our probably our most produced show to the last show that we were developing that we never got quite to premiere, but it's a show called Moonshine in B Minor. It is about race relations in America in the 1920s, not a complicated time at all. The piece deals with this young Nigerian-American soldier who falls in love with an Irish nurse and their communities and what happens with those biracial communities to try to reconcile their differences. This particular part in the piece, this young girl has lost her husband, who is now traveling through the Yoruba underworld, and she decides to go face the devil to try to bring him back. So she takes her own life in this piece called Whatever Happens to the Dead and wonders what it means to find her love in the afterworld. So here is the wonderful Chris Roberts doing Whatever Happens to the Dead from Moonshine in B Minor.
There was a ringing when I left you, a searing silence in my ear, a wall inside my throat, I could not speak or hear. I reached out my hands to hold you, I searched the wind to find your trace, but could I see you through the darkness as you reached another place? Double-sided knife. I don't know. I don't know. What happens to the dead when their body passes on? What happens to the dead when they're gone? What happens to the lungs? Can the lung draw a breath? What happens to the thought after death? Up at the dawn to the dark again. The threshold. Was taken from me all the colors.
Chris Roberts and I met at a theater company when I first started my career, which was called Nightstar, if anybody hears from Nightstar. She was also in my first concert so many, many years ago. So just so grateful. Thank you, Chris, for wrapping this cycle with me. Cool. So now we're going to move into our thing about death, although I feel like that's all we've been talking about. So I curate the main shows, not the little cabaret one. No, I do. This is all my fault. I don't know who I'm deflecting to. All right. So I'm going to fight with myself now. The next piece we're going to do is from a show called A Drink with Death. A Drink with Death is a cabaret series we started at 54 Below. This one is a piece that I co-wrote with one of the co-founders of Mind the Art, which is Joe Kurtz. So just a huge shout out to Joe Kurtz, who writes The Weird and Existential. This one piece called Le Grand Mort is somebody who has been locked up by Lady Death, La Muerte, who is the gatekeeper to hell, into a little cage, and she just sings all day about dying while having an orgasm, because this amuses Lady Death. In the show itself, Lady Death offers tequila to the audience to get to thumbs up or thumbs down whether people go to heaven or hell. It's very raunchy and stupid. So here is Le Grand Mort with Emma Grimsley from A Drink with Death.
Le Grand Mort, your whole body shivers, your bowels abort. Le Grand Mort, your fingers and toes all bend and contort. You'd climax for days, but your life is cut short. Petit Mort, French say, after sex, a little death that we call climax. Just before death, bang, and you're gone. You get a big treat before you move on. You may have orgasms, both and short. Yes, short.
Always keep it really, really classy with all of our works. So this next piece is also from A Drink with Death, and it is a piece also written by Joseph Rhys Anderson called Death is Not an Option. And we had written this song a couple of years ago, And Joe himself, our librettist, identifies as half black and half Native American and has been troubled over the last couple of years and with a particular new resonance about just all the continuing injustices. And so we had written this song and he said, you know, I would love to hear this song just sung by a black man about what I feel is going on today. And so Bernard Holcomb is doing me the wonderful favor of showing us this piece this evening. I've known Bernard for many years. He's an incredible artist. Thank you for being here with us from your busy, busy schedule. It's a song about a man who is looking at death in the eyes at the end of his times and says, no, I'm not ready, and I refuse to die. So this is Death Is Not an Option from A Drink with Death.
Death is not an option, that is, it's not the time. There's an exquisite home you should visit, but not mine. Death is not an option, give me a warning instead. Stop me from breathing one day when I'm sleeping in my bed. I've got so much to live for. Please don't stop me here. What would I hope to give for another moment to live for, even if I live in fear? Death is not an option. I fear the dreams I dare to dream. I fear running. I fear falling, I find flying flat appalling. No, I cannot bear a creature calling. I swear I'm not just stalling. I might scream. I've got no one to save. If I hear the danger coming, I'm the one that's running. I'm not clever, I'm not cunning. I came to be or not to be, that is the question put to me. Who can bear the whips and scorns but that the fear unknown bonds, unknown waters, unknown shores, to die, to wish to sleep, perchance to dream. Death is not an option, let's discuss this more at length. Let me try my hand at dealing. I can't stop while someone's stealing all my strength. Death is not an option. Sit down, I'll tell you how I feel. The light is fake, the peace is real.
Oh, now the sad part of the show. Okay. So I just want to talk a little bit about Mind the Art before we do this next number. So, you know, I said Mind the Art was founded in 2007. Since that time, we've helped put together or guide or produce 1,000 productions. We have artists who have worked in all five continents. We have people go to great success through what we've done. We've gotten reviewed with critics' picks from 32 different publications. We've won every festival we've ever been in. And we somehow always survived without any kind of major sponsorship of any kind. It was all artists from 26 different disciplines coming together to put art. So with that said, I just want to give a huge moment to say I'm so sad that it's ending, but I'm so grateful for every second of every one of those people who got me here and anything I could have done to help get them where they are. And so just thank you to every fan, every supporter, every co-writer, every artist, every Bernard, every human who has worked with us for all these years. And specifically, I just want to say thank you to four people. Patrick Alberti, who has associated with this director for so many years. To Brian Freeland, who has put up with me in so many ways as our managing director, our director, lighting designer, tree cutter, putter upper builder. to Thomas Michael Culhane. Who I have been abusing for almost 10 years. Just the most wonderful human. He has been associate producer, executive assistant, master carpenter, many, everything you need a whole plugged at a Mind the Art show. There was T. Mike, and thank you, thank you. And lastly, to Daniel Stucka, who was a fan of our shows. We kept finding him lurking, coming to all of our productions of this weird little show called Die Roll to Proceed. And he just kept appearing. And then one day I was legitimately homeless, didn't have anywhere to live, and Daniel said, come stay with me and continue your art. That was 10 years ago, and I currently am living at Daniel's in Brooklyn. he is, you know, had one of our largest donors for the company, a huge supporter in so many ways, ended up becoming part of our board when we were restructuring. Just, I cannot thank him enough. So to Daniel, thank you. And now to bid farewell to Mind the Art, we will sing a song. This is not the last song of the show. Don't get excited. You're stuck with me for a little bit longer. But we're going to do a song from Acedia, which is a song that ended in that play, The Apocalypse. There's a family that's looking out the window as the world is coming to an end, and they're holding each other as they cannot figure out a way to reconcile their feelings. And there's a song as their whole world ends called Let It Burn. So here is Let It Burn from Acedia.
The glow is so pretty. Orange, yellow, white, and blue. Dancing on the walls, and the heat is cozy too. This may feel like a song someone has already sung. There's a smell that hints of camping that reminds of being young.
A little pop, a little hiss, those are the moments that you miss. Crackling fire, a melty smoke, why can't we do that anymore?
Watch the light, watch the glow, take a breath and watch the show.
Have a seat, enjoy the heat. These last few moments are the last you know. Let it burn,
watch the coal, feel the spark, things aren't so simple in the dark. Let it melt, like the feelings that you never
So for the last couple of numbers, we've got two more songs for you. This is a part of the show where I talk about resilience. So yes, the company is closing, but we are, as artists, are continuing. So this is one of the pieces that I was working on developing at BMI and at Yaddo. There's some Yaddo folks here. Hi, love you all. Space on Rider and a couple of places. It is about the Mexican-American War, and so it is a stop. It's a seven-part stop-motion animated operetta cycle I'm developing, because that's the way to go after this. About the Mexican-American War, told through seven different viewpoints, about seven different cultural groups that were affected from it. I'm not going to give you a whole history lesson because we don't have time. But in this one particular number that we're going to do, it is the American forces trying to break into Mexico City. They were led by this man who you might have heard of named Robert E. Lee. So before Robert E. Lee became a huge Confederate icon, he earned his stripes by essentially murdering children in Mexico City. No one was surprised. So, yes, we're going to go there. We're going to do our number from Robert E. Lee as he is trying to walk through lava. This actually happened. He actually walked through old volcanic rock to reach Mexico City and find a pathway in that allowed him to conquer the city faster. So here is Charlie Tingen playing Robert E. Lee in A Rope of Fire from 1848.
Long ago, a volcano erupted here. It burst open, spit lava all around. Now the field is molten rock, there's no way to cross that ground. We'll cut through the field to the other side. They left the path unguarded and clear. They'll be surprised and be destroyed, but God has a plan for who's meant to be here. I don't want children to honor my name. But when I see something that has to be done, I do it because I'm the only one who can. I can walk across the lava with the blessing of the night. I can walk across the lava. I say with certainty that I'm right. I can walk across the lava, cut right through the fiery field. I can walk across the lava to get what's needed to make them yield. And I act for God, and in God do I trust. And I act for God, and in God I trust. It's really an art to reconnaissance, finding what comes up ahead. The scout sees the future and then brings back the news. What I say will shape how the battle is led. This field is in some ways a burning bush. It's fire, yes, but also it's more a test that allows me to listen to God. Fight like Jacob and win this war.
watching and lighting the fuse. I can wheel the rope of fire, hold it tightly in my hand. I can wheel the rope of fire, I whip and I lasso to claim Christian land. God's land, God, I don't wish for ruin, I don't wish for harm, I don't wish for my name to engender alarm. But when I see something that has to be done, I do it because I'm the only one who can. I can wield a rope of fire, turning sword to ashy dust. I can wield a rope of fire, I only do what I know I must. And God alone judges what is just. And I act for God, and in God do I trust. And I act for God, and in God I trust.
That is the only time you can clap at Robert E. Lee. Just so we're clear, before this becomes some sort of scandal on Twitter I deal with later, this is the one time you can clap at Robert Lee. All right, so I do want to thank Sarah Sanders and Elias Ubadias, who are my co-writers for 1848. Elias actually was my best friend in Mexico when we were like 5 years old, and we met on Facebook 20 years later, and he's our lead animator. It's great. I'll show you all at some point. I don't know when. We're not going to do one of these again, but at some point I'll show you art. Okay. We're going to do our final number, although if you're allowed after that, we will have an encore, but I never said that. I do this every time. Tony's like, you made the same joke last week. But we're going to do a piece from the same show, 1848. There was a company of Irish and Mexican soldiers who banded together. Irish because of the persecution they were getting for being Catholic, and Mexicans because they were having their territory invaded, who got together to try to fight Robert E. Lee's last attack on Chapultepec Castle. Among all of these soldiers were some very young ones, ranging down to the ages from 12 all the way to people in their 40s, who essentially defended the last stand Mexico did. So here is that moment as they're watching the Americans come into Mexico City. And we see a young soldier calling out for his mother as he says, I'm going to not stand down, but I will fight till the very end. So here is Tony Mowat from 1848 with Mama, I Remember.
I want to take 30 seconds real quick because there's some wonderful people that Christian pointed out in the audience. And among those people, and Christian included, changed my life. And I speak for many people when I say that. 5 years ago, I was a silly little 27-year-old or whatever, didn't know anything about the business, really. And on backstage, I applied to Whiskey Pants, and he gave me a shot. And he brought me in, and that show changed my life. I got my agent from that show. I got a girlfriend for a little while from that show. And I met family and some of the best friends that I still have to this day. And I'm not the only one that Christian and the wonderful people in this room have done that for. Literally changed my life. I would not have what I have today if Christian and his team did not give me a chance 5 years ago. So thank you.
Mama, I remember when you gave me this watch. You said, look at the way that the numbers go round. We split up a day into something called hours and minutes and seconds. The ticking sound. Right before you got sick,
When you said that you wondered who I become as I grew, for men can be made in a number of ways. But mama, all I want is to be like you. Oh, mama, I remember you said when you're lost, you can look into places. The watch tells the time, and time is always true. And your heart will point you if you really listen. When the time comes, you'll know what to do. They say it's too late now, it's the end of the war, but 6:33 is too soon. How can this end when we can give so much more? Mama, I am looking at my heart and your watch. Mama, they are telling me that we're not through. Why should the general decide that it's over? He will never know what you know. That a fight isn't something that you do 'cause it's easy, when you know that you'll win before shots hit the sky, for they have more people and cannons and guns, but we have a reason to fight until we die. Oh, mama, I remember. Morning shows we can win. I believe we can win. Mama, I remember when you gave me this watch. You told me that this country was our family too. And the minutes and hours would make me its son. Well, now the time has come for me to fight for you.
Do an encore, not that I primed that and asked for that to happen. It's the best way. Just be honest with an audience and you'll get what you want for your video later. All right, so we're going to do just one final number as our final piece. Before we do that, I want to say just one very last quick thank you and then a toast. And my last thank you is a couple of, last week maybe actually, my grandmother passed away. And we've lost a lot of really great people in the last 2 years. Mind the Art alone has lost 6 different artists since the pandemic started through various reasons. And my grandmother, it was this tiny little Mayan woman. We used to call her Yoda. She was amazing and always taught me to dream and always taught me to persevere no matter what. And was very excited to get the video of the show, but didn't unfortunately make it. So to my past, I just want to say thank you to Zoila and for getting me to this point and for always believing in me. And one of the other things the pandemic brought is my life changed drastically. And I now have a wonderful new partner. Her name is Kaden. We have a beautiful boy that is now part of my life named Gael, who's right there. We met at the top of the pandemic on Tinder when the pandemic started and I did a tour of 32 cities and chaos and like anarchy, the world is burning, I don't care anymore, running from everything place. But in through all of that, I found Karen randomly through a weird happenstance. And she's saved my life. She has changed my life. She's inspired me to work. And as I say goodbye to my grandmother, Zoila, who was my inspiration for all these years, I welcome this new energy that is now this family that I have for the future. Gracias, hermano. And I just want anybody who still has a drink, although I think everyone's cashed out because I took too long. But anybody who still has a drink, I just want to say to all the dreamers, to all the artists, to anybody who is affiliated in any way to Mind the Art or not, to anybody who has a dream, anybody who cares, anybody who thinks that things might get better even if they don't, but we're still going to do it anyway, to the alchemists in our lives who just try to make gold out of the shit that is existence, I just want to say, raise a glass to you, and let's celebrate ourselves. So cheers. And now we end with a song that is called Face the World. See, it's all together. It's all tied together.
Spur of the moment.
So there's another piece from Beware the Chupacabra. At this point, Teddy Baskins and his little monster are trying to figure out a way to just say, I'm going to defy it all. And I'm just going to do it, and I'm going to face the world. So here's Charlie Tingen and Chris Roberts to close us out with Face the World from Beware the Chupacabra.
So far away from the world, you have known. I know it's unfair to be pressed in the crowd and yet still feel so every sight and each sound, like the world's come unwound, and the madness will swallow you whole. You reach out for the past, but the distance is vast, and you're falling fast, out of control. And you wish you could hide, but then there by your side is a friend who will calm you and say, it's all okay. Come and face the world. For your faith when you're near to me, I used to sow from dusk to dawn. I slaved all day until these wilds beyond. I will trust you, you will trust me, and together we will go. You and me can make them see what they thought could never be. I have spent all my days looking for one good thing, and now I find that the one thing. Please meet tonight, for so long, with your talents galore, with this creature of lore, we will find what's been waiting for us for so long.
We were
you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I do want to make sure you get to know who our band is. So, who have put up with me for many, many, many years, these three humans. Ed, who on bass clarinet. Sam Quiggins on cello. Sarah, who always tells me after every rehearsal, you still not writing right for violin. I'm like, I know, one day I'll get there. Sarah, the amazing violinist. A wonderful Brandon on drums. And our musical director to close us out, Ron Land. Thank you. I am deeply grateful to every single one of you who's here. It means the world to me. Let's go get drunk and talk about our woes. Thank you very much. Have a good night.